Is somebody getting what I'm saying? So what do we do when the opposites attract? What do we do? Well, number one, you need to appreciate that difference. Appreciate who your partner is. You see, awareness or perspective goes a long way. I need my first of all, thank you. Awareness goes a long way. The moment I realize that me and my partner are opposites, goes a long way. Awareness, be aware. What are the differences between you and your partner? There will always be differences. The strongest relationships are usually opposites. Remember, not opposites in values. Oh. Not that me, I believe in God, they don't believe in God. So the opposites attract. No, that's not what I mean. Not in values. I'm talking about personality types. So awareness, just knowing that, oh, she actually has something to say, but she usually will not say it. So that awareness helps me realize that it's not that she doesn't have opinion. Because there are many men, the way they lead their homes, just make a decision. Say, we decided. It's not we decided. She never said anything. Only you said it. And she didn't even have power to oppose you. Because the one time she tried to talk, you used your 1,000 words to crush her 2 words. So she said, no need. She'll keep all her thoughts in her mind. Hallelujah. Awareness. This scattered person, if you know that, see, an organized person will marry a scattered person. Two scattered people can't marry. They will scatter the relationship. That's what happens. So an organized person marries a scattered person. When you understand that this is how my partner is, that I'm even, the thing I'm complaining about is what I'm even sent to solve in their life. So you understand where it's coming from. Then if you're married to the organized person, you also understand where she's coming from. Because for the organized person, things not being organized stresses them out. Totally stresses. And we the scattered people don't know what is wrong with you. The scattered person is a full-time fire brigade officer. Scattered people, are you here with me? We are many. We are permanently fire brigade officers. Everything is last minute. Everything is what? Last minute. We are never on time. Everything is last minute. It's like me saying, where is my shoe? Where is my passport? The day is traveling. The hour is traveling. The day you will look for his passport. Is somebody getting what I'm saying? But the organized person, 2 weeks before the time, he has kept the passport, the boarding pass, everything they are going to use, they've kept it in one place. Organized people are so irritating. If you move anything where they kept, if it shifts, no. They'll say, who touched this thing? You see, just awareness. Awareness can go a long way. Being aware. Hallelujah. That this is how this person is and I'm different. You would now, after awareness, the next level is acceptance. Accept their difference. Accept it. Your job is not to change anybody. You can't change any human being. Accept them. You'll be happier in life if you accept them for who they are. That this, my husband, is scattered. His mother tried to change him for 30 years. He didn't change. I'm not the one that will change him. Isn't this is causing frustration in people's homes? You want to change a man that has been scattered since they born him? A scattered person, when he enters the house, he's dropping all his clothing items at 1 mile. I'll be 1 meter as he's going. From the door, he drop his suit. Near the step, he drop his tie. First landing of step, he drop one shoe. Second landing, drop one socks. You can shout at him every day. Or when he enters, you go and pick up everything from where he bought. Trust me, it looks difficult, but you'll be happier. Awareness, number one. Number two is what? Accept them. They are planners. You see, when you accept them, for instance, if you're a scattered person and you married an organized person, acceptance means to allow them organize our life. I get what I'm saying? If you are the spender, let the saver organize your finances. But the spender, we think he's making good financial decisions. No, he's racking the hours like that. Oh, I finished our money. It's not a joke. It's not a joke. I was a financial rolling stone. I was a financial wreck. And I had faith and I was making money. I'm blessed. So as I make the money, I spend it. A spender slogan is money is for spending. What are we saving money for? Jesus can come anytime. A spender. A spender is always taken by surprise. School fees always comes to him by surprise. That is it you again?
Of course it's due.
You knew from the beginning of the year all the points will be due. But you're acting surprised. Rent comes to him as surprise. Rent again? Yes. Because the saver has everything planned. He saves all through the year for his rent at the end of the year. But the spender believes before that time reach. There are plenty. Pastor, I think your church is full of spenders. There are too many in this place. There are too many in this place. So, Mr. Spender, acceptance means to allow the saver organize the finances. Change our life. Change our life. I'm a big spender. I make money in big way and I also spend it like that. Until I began to become aware of both my partner and myself and began to accept that God sent her into my life with that unique skill to help me. That's why two spenders would be a disaster. That's what I'm saying. Opposites are usually better. Once people similar marry, they will be very strong in one area and also very weak. Two spenders, their children are perpetually praying for their parents. That Lord help my parents to have school fees. Because two of them are equally shocked when school fees is due. Spender parents, their children are used to being driven from school regularly. Because spender parents will never be ready. Are you here? Two talkative parents will never listen to anybody. They both talk, nobody listens. Are you here, somebody? Two organized people will never take any risk. Because, see, the balance, that is what makes marriage beautiful. The difference actually brings the balance that two of you need. Because when two risk-averse people marry, should we wake up? It's risky. I don't think it's a good idea. Neither do I. Let's stay here. They will never make any decision. When two incurable optimists also marry, they will always bet too big. Let's put all our investment in Bitcoin. Let's sell our land. I'm putting Bitcoin in selling now. Is somebody getting what I'm saying? They are too reckless. Too reckless. The balance brings safety for you guys. You begin to appreciate it. You begin to what? Appreciate it. Hope you're writing. That's number what? Number one is awareness. Number two is what? Number three is what? Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Hey, if not for my wife saving, if not for my wife organizing, hey, on this trip, we're going to preach in, I don't know how many places we're going to preach, but in the next 2 weeks, I'm going to be traveling. I preached in Ikeja on Thursday. I flew to Ilorin on Friday morning. I left home 5 a.m., got to Ilorin, preached Friday evening in Ilorin, preached Saturday morning and evening in Ilorin, preached Sunday in Ilorin for 3 hours on Sunday morning, straight. Monday, which is today, I flew into Abuja. I'm preaching now. I'm going to preach here Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Take a break on Thursday. Friday, I'm flying to Port Harcourt. I'll preach Saturday morning, Saturday evening, Sunday morning. Then from there, I'm also going to you. So we had to pack all the things we wear for all the services. I don't know how many services. We have to pack it, about 12. We have to pack it. I was not a part of that packing at all. If it's left to me, I'll bring down 2 or 3 shares. I'll be buying the remaining when I get here. Telling you, appreciate it. That difference is a blessing. Now I appreciate my wife. She will sit down. This will wear on Monday, this will wear on Tuesday, this will wear. Hey, organizing wears me out. See, one time we're in Canada, we just finished preaching in Canada, and we're about to travel back the next day. I said, my wife was already packing a day before, packing all the things. Hey, I was so... You see, these are the things that will make your marriage last happy, because when you appreciate it, the thing that you were pouring into each other that made you attract, it will come back. So I was just looking at her, organizing her, she was packing all the clothes, pam, 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 but we're traveling next day. Next day, for a scattered person, that's too early to start preparing. We still have how many hours to go out and go and shop. I don't even know if I will still buy something this night. But an organizer, the next day, we pack. When I saw the way she was packing all our things, I told her, honey, come and peck me. And she was smiling. She didn't know why. I said, just peck me first. She now pecked me. She said, okay, why am I pecking you? I said, because I just want to appreciate myself. That I shall be married. I shall be married. I'm a married good woman. That's why I'm pleasing myself. And because I can't peck myself, I need somebody to help peck me. I get what I'm saying. You start to appreciate it. You that you're so serious. Don't you know your life will be too serious if you don't marry an unserious person? Haven't you seen some people that they take everything too seriously in life? Have you met those people? Everything is serious. We are going to church this evening. Carry your Bible. Yes. One step at a time. Everything is serious. God will usually connect you with somebody very unserious. You know those unserious people that no matter what's going on, everything is a joke. Even when there's serious problem, they will turn it to a joke. You see, that balance makes you healthy. If two very serious people marry, they usually get high blood pressure. Because they will think too much. They will take everything too seriously. It's a balance to help you. And your serious person needs a serious person in his life. Because he will take everything on seriously. The balance brings the beauty. You begin to appreciate it. I look at my wife today, I'm happy. I hope she too is happy. When she looks at what she married. That's why I was pecking myself. I can't speak for you. So let me that I can appreciate myself. Come and peck me. Sometimes she can be so serious. So I make her laugh. You understand? I make her laugh. I remember that one time. She entered the bath because she's the kind of person that she wants to have a bath. Before she has a bath, she has to lay her clothes on the bed. Hey, organize people, you're weird. Me, I go and bath without knowing what I'm going to wear. When I come out, by the Spirit, I will know what to wear. I don't know what I'm going to wear. I just bath. Even if I'm running late, it doesn't matter. I just bath and come out and say, this one go. They now wear one shirt after their stomach has grown big. You know, enter. There are too many scattered people in this church, Pastor. They have to form an association here. My wife will lay down what she's going to wear before she even starts to have a bath. So one day she entered, laid down her underwear, everything, her dress, entered. Before she came back, I had one underwear, top and bottom. And I lay on the bed section. She used to laugh. Life is not that serious. You can't be too organized. You begin to actually appreciate it. I began to appreciate our finances for the first time. Because I actually saw that we could actually have money after we have spent. We can have something left. Before that time, all money that enters also goes. I don't buy many things, but anything I buy usually empties the account. If you are married to a spender, I'll get to that point. If you are married to a spender, never show him all the money. Never show him. If there's 100K available, tell him it's only 20K in that account. He will finish that 20K. Then one day you will need 80K badly. Then you tell him, okay, I can give you another 20K. He will say, you have 20K? He will now love you. I love you. That's why I love you. That's why I love you. Because remember, he's a fire brigade officer. There will always be fire to put out. There will always be fire to put out. So number one is what? What's number one? Awareness. What's number two? Acceptance. What's number three? Appreciation. Then number four, adjustment. Adjustment. Adjust to the person. Like I mentioned earlier, if you are married to a spender, don't show him all the money. After a while, he will start to learn that, this girl saved me. Rent was due. And she actually had savings. I used to be surprised. My wife always had money. I was like, you have money. Because we run a joint account. So I'm surprised when we share some money to go and spend, she will keep her own. Then you will need it badly. She will just bring out, you have money in this house. So I began to actually appreciate the fact that, it's good to have money. Oh. This is my spending lifestyle. I won't work. Oh. So adjust. He scatters his things. Pick it up. He scatters his things. Put a dirty cloth basket where he can see it. See, only put it in here. When he throws it in his presence, take it and put it there. He'll be getting the idea. Because everybody's work in progress. The person that always looks like they won't change today, eventually, if you love them enough, they will change. Adjustment. Your wife likes to organize, so give her heads up and allow her. Let whoever is strong in an area lead in that area. You know you're not a good in financial management. Let who is better with money. So how do we know who's better in money? Who has money left? Is the better person. Let them manage. Let them manage the family finances. So you submit, you adjust and submit to that person's leadership. Somebody get what I'm saying? Who is better at it? Adjust. Hallelujah. Adjust. So after you go through these stages, you know, the adjustment stage is where you become intentional. Because at the beginning, you were actually adjusting, but you were doing it from an emotional standpoint. So the way I normally say it is that you must move from emotional love to intentional love. You must move from what? Emotional love to what? Intentional love. Most marriages, when they hit anywhere from 6 months to 2 years, they begin to feel that they married the wrong person. They begin to feel, I need a new spouse. The reason is because the opposite then has become apparent. So it's not frustrating them. What they need to realize is that there was a time those opposites were very attractive. So what you need to do is to now move from emotional love to intentional love. You see, emotional love is why they say love is blind. Because most things that break a marriage existed even before the marriage started. It's just that love or emotions, that euphoric stage, makes you not to pay attention to it. You are very okay. The person that always comes late was coming late when you were dating. If you check it, he used to come late. He will tell you, I'll be there by 4, he'll be there by 6. But because you missed him so much, he said, I miss you. You came late, but I miss you. You even hug him. When you marry, when people have a flight to catch, and it's 2 hours late, to frustrate you. That's why they say love is blind. What they mean is that when you're in that euphoric stage, you are not noticing that both of you are opposites. You are naturally complementing each other. So what you need to do is, now that the euphoric stage has gone, because it will go. Emotions were never meant to control us. We were meant to control it. So there are usually three phases of every emotion. Where the emotion is high, where it is low, when it's high again. Now, the way it works is that when it was high the first time, it wasn't your control, it was it just being high. When it goes low, it's natural. Emotions, nobody can be on an emotional high forever. Now, the next thing is that when you start doing some things intentionally to build the emotion, it now comes up again. The difference is that first one, because you didn't start it, it means you can't determine when it will go. But the second one, because you are the one doing something to make it high, you can sustain it. That is what true love now becomes. I don't know if somebody's got what I'm saying.